That last video ended abruptly.
Another day, another septum.
So I guess this one will start abruptly.
No, I'm not. I feel like my scales are clawing into me. Maybe you could help an old Argonian out? I heard some of the sailors talking about how they stashed a bottle of double-distilled skooma in the Nissus Corner Club. I just need a taste.
Rigmore's trying to get to where I'm standing.
Thank you. I'll be waiting for that bottle.
The pathfinding is terrible in this hallway here. Rigmore! It's Rigmore!
Not much, but I hope you like them.
Okay, what's wrong with this picture?
Stop by again.
Oh, is her hat bigger than her head? I can't tell. I may have to tweak little hoods for kids so that things look smaller. I need a before-after picture so I can really tell the difference. Her flower basket, I was curious if she had like 500 baskets in her inventory. But that doesn't show up unless you make her a follower, and then you look at her inventory that way.
Thanks. Thanks for talking to me.
Because when she switches over from animated object, or was it inanimate? When she switches from inanimate object to follower, it has to convert her inventory magically from a script to something else that will work with follower schemes. And during that process, it fills the inventory up with
Since
flower
we
baskets.
Since the elves and lizards live here, the city has started to rot.
And depending on how jammed the script gets, that determines how many flowers or flower baskets you get in the kids' whatever. So when you try to give the kids something, you're told, oh, they can't carry anymore. Then you look at their inventory and they're like, holy crap, they only need one basket. What's with the... Because if you steal all the baskets from the kid and then you let the kid go free in the wild, they'll start collecting baskets again. So each time you come running into Windhelm, it spawns a bunch of baskets. Where's the thing? That was like right here. It's weird. Sometimes I find it without a torch, and then here I am with a torch, and I need help finding it still. It's been a while since I've done this quest because
If you need me, I'd be honored to accompany you.
I've had a mod
Safe
that's...
travels.
For years, I was using a mod that would break this quest, so I was never able to do this quest. Getting the double dip skooma for somebody outside. The skooma whore addicted breaks that little skooma bottle. So when you pick it up, the quest doesn't advance. Because skooma whore addicted replaces all the skooma bottles and all the double distilled ones with its own little concoctions.
I'm still here. I'll be sure to put it to good use. Lead on, then.
The reason why I don't have Skooma Whore Addicted installed in this playthrough is I don't recall which... There's so many versions of it. You know, they put stuff on GitHub and people start patching it and updating it, and next thing you know, there's 30 versions of a mod. All of them kind of suck in their own little way.
Another day, another septum. Thank you so much. Here, let me show you a thing or two about not attracting attention to yourself.
Okay, I can barely see her. I can barely see her face, man.
Right. Yeah?
Aye.
Anyway, so I'm thinking of,
Yeah?
Good day.
Using a male body replacer. Because I miss not having toes. I look down at my feet and I don't see my toes.
It's been hard on my people. Bless you, friend. You've renewed my hope. Before I came into Xenophar's calling, I confess I was a thief. But I learned a few things in my time that might help you survive. Let me show you. Until our next meeting, honored friend.
But the thing is, I think these male replacers also come with beast male replacers, so I don't want my beast getting broken, because they have perfect feet. They have all their toes. And they've got that certain kind of joint in their ankle / kneecap that's different than the human dudes.
Nords don't appreciate us. So what?
I don't want that getting broken.
Right back. All right then.
I don't remember what that mod's called. It.
Looking to hire a boat?
Makes the Khajiits and the Argonians use different
legs.
Climb
on in the boat and get comfortable.
So we get to Dawnstar and I'm using my telescopic view. And I see this fight going on. Somebody's fighting some vampires, I thought. And then I get over there and it's werewolves. So it's like, what's going on here? So the vampires, they dissolved. They faded away. And then the werewolves spawned in their place. I'd never seen that before. In a playthrough.
You may defeat me, Satan. You stupid milk drinker.
So whenever there's a full moon, that's when the werewolves show up in the cities.
Interesting outfit you are wearing today. Was it your idea?
You know, Dawnstar is so beautiful.
What?
So it was not your choice then.
Hey, don't look at me. Wait, who are you to judge me?
Rigmor assumes we came to Dawnstar from the front entrance instead of the back door. Because normally, I think she would. I don't know.
Absolutely disgusting.
Honestly,
some of the keywords I question.
A little friendly advice: take a bath and get some new clothes.
Good idea.
Oh, so right now in my game, I've got every Imperial on the planet is coming after me. And I don't know what I did to upset the entire Imperial army, because I'm a member of the Imperials. So I'm hoping that'll cool off, or that spell, or whatever it is, will cool down. Another werewolf? We killed you! You're supposed to be dead! I forget what I was talking about. Oh, I guess I have to go rewind my tape. Oh, that's right. The Imperial Army is out to get me. You know, when you're going down a road and you see those three Imperials and they're just chit-chatting about why they joined the Legion. You know, the default Skyrim soldiers that ignore pretty much anything you're doing. Now, all of a sudden, they've taken a real interest in my whereabouts constantly. Maybe I've murdered one too many of them. And they've caught on that's what I've been doing. If I see three of them out on the road with no one else around, I like practicing killing them all. And then, you know, you get that message that you killed the last witness, so there's no bounty. I think that's really cool. So I'm getting really, really good at killing the last witness. But maybe in one of my travels, I didn't get the last witness. Or there was a script lag or a jam somewhere. Because when I look at my, you know, high crimes and misdemeanors, where
Whitemane is in a better place now.
There's no bounty. There's no, like, global bounty that I know of. Yeah, it was a full moon. That's why there was werewolves. But yet everyone acts like I'm wanted criminal. I don't know if the Imperials can even arrest you or not. I don't think that's what they do. I think they just kill you. Now the guards, I don't know. Maybe I should just go visit every little town and talk to a guard and see which one says, "Hey, I know you." So maybe my bounty is like 0.5 gold, and that's not enough to even register when I look to see what my crimes are.
Ranmir beg a drink from you yet? That's gold wasted, friend. Hello.
Oh, hi. I'm glad I ran into you. I was wondering if you...
Hello, ladies. Is there anything a big, strong man can do for you this fine day?
I don't like doing business with Azura's faithful. Make it quick. Just leave.
Okay, good.
Silence. Do not speak unless spoken to.
Oh, come now.
We have nothing to talk about.
So he's pretty much locked me out of his life. That's RDO doing that to me. I sided with the Azura woman.
I'm not fretting. I don't want Irid playing those sorts of games.
All right. I'll speak to her.
I was looking for somebody here. Who was I looking for? I don't remember. There's only one follower I have installed at that location.
Is there anything I can do for you?
I think. Where are we at anyway? We're in Winterhold now? I thought we were in Dawnstar still. How did we get here?
Anytime.
Looks like we're leaving Winterhold now. It's hard to say. Around this point, I started trying out different mods, getting rid of the mods, trying different mods all day yesterday. I spent all day yesterday playing with new faces and new hairstyles for women. A year ago, I was told about Hairstyler, so I still had that on my hard drive, so I put that back in. Gave it another chance. I read the fine print that explains why it does what it does. so I can probably live with that. Not all the hairstyles are worth using. Some of the hairstyles look terrible on certain NPCs. Doesn't have all the colors for hair. Not all the hairs have textures to them. They're just color, solid color. So you say, put some black hair on this person. That's literally what it does. The hair is black. There's no texture of any kind. No highlights. Nothing, just solid black. Like someone took a MS Paint brush and just painted black on someone's hair. And then there's God. G-O-D-D. Oh. Wow, I know in the past, whenever I would come back to this location, I would get bum rushed. But that was usually from mods. Like immersive creatures or monster mod or... I was not expecting that to happen in this playthrough. Usually I come up here the first time and there's Thalmor waiting for me, and then all the other times, nothing. Maybe a bear or a saber cat might be up here. Anyway, so I've got the god statue installed. It replaces the Talos statues throughout the game. Except the one in Windhelm. The one in Windhelm, inside of the Talos shrine, that one's left alone. But I ended up taking out the god statue because it's sloppily thrown together. So it doesn't fill the same space that the Talos statue filled. So you got weird clipping issues. Not these guys again. So my game's been crashing a lot recently. Is that a companion? He just happened to be walking by?
Good to see you. We've received a desperate missive. A citizen of Whiterun has been kidnapped. The companions have been asked for assistance, and we shall answer. Particularly when the pay is as good as this. Get moving. I shudder to think what might happen if you're too late.
Yeah, so my game's been crashing a lot. But it's not like annoying kind of crashes or hard to solve issues or bug-ridden crashes. It's just me reaching a point where I've got too much stuff going on at once. Like at a real role-playing session at a table, you got players sitting around the table. If you have too many players, half of them don't know how to play the game. and they want to try something for their turn and they don't understand the rules, they have to open up the book to read the rule to see how to do what it is they want to do is done. And everyone knows that when you have to open up the book at a roleplay session, the game's basically halted. It was slowly crawling as it was. You know the typical roleplay game session where you got players goofing off and they don't care about nothing except filling in their character sheet during the game. They ask too many questions. They're playing a Mother May I game session instead of role-playing. So already the game's at a snail's pace. Then when two or three players start looking in the book to see how to beat the game, that's basically what my Skyrim's been doing. Skyrim, the engine's looking at the plugins I have installed, and it's like, what does this plugin do exactly? Here, let me read the fine print here. And then basically the game has to stop while the game engine tries to sort things out. Because I just have too much stuff going on. Stuff's happening out of sequence. All it takes is something simple like a fire wizard wants to go after some female Stormcloak for whatever reason. He's got some sort of an attraction towards her. And before he can do his little spell on her, she fades away, because she's just a minion in the game. She's not a full-on NPC. You know, she's got a timed limit in the game. She serves her purpose during a battle scene, then she's gone. And that will kill Skyrim in a heartbeat. Because the fire mage is like, where'd she go? Oh no, she can't just disappear. I've queued a magic spell against her. And I got a critical hit, so where's my critical hit that the game owes me? Where are we going? Oh, we're going to, is it Orthheim or something? What's that place called? Oh no, this is, what's this? We're going to that place with the ghosts. The ghosts are standing outside saying things like, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do it. I was told there's a word wall in the place. Maybe, I have too many quests. That's the problem. Too many quests. I'm not paying attention to what I'm supposed to be doing. I just see the arrow pointing at a location. I'm thinking, oh, I can get there and back. And I get there, not really realizing what I'm supposed to even be doing. Am I supposed to rescue someone? Retrieve a family heirloom? Kill bandits? We've been waiting for her to show up with her snowman. Oh, the sun's coming up. That's good. Oh, this place? The moon place? This is a place where my game will crash. Because I got too many lightning bolts doing chain lightning. Chain lightning really puts a halt to your character's momentum. And if your character is doing something complicated, when they get hit by chain lightning, it's over. It's all over. Where are you going? The fight's in front of you. Oh, just in time. So my Jamora did turn around. Can I get these guys? Nope, I wasn't even paying attention. For all I know, I had zero health, for all I know.